In Kandiyohi County, Minnesota Board of Water and Soil Resources staff recently worked with Hulkrin Farms on a wetland restoration. Bowser received a grant from the USDA's Natural Resources Conservation Service through their Wetland Mitigation Banking Program. The goal associated with the grant funds is to develop mitigation banks with credits that can be used by producers in the USDA Farm Program. You will see the progression of this site in the historic aerial photos starting in 1938, when all four of the wetlands had not yet been drained, and ending with the recent photo and a certified wetland determination indicating the wetlands had been effectively drained over the years. This land was drained by subsurface tile and contained one shallow ditch. The restoration work disabled the existing drainage, embankments were built, and overflow outlets were installed that could effectively manage the water levels even during extreme rainfall events. Grant funds allowed Bowser's staff to provide technical assistance and develop the mitigation bank plan for this project. This project is expected to generate 25 wetland credits. It was pretty amazing to watch as the restoration work resulted in almost an immediate change, going from completely drained farmland to having ponded water and starting to look like a wetland in less than 9 days after the restoration work was completed. All wetland restorations provide significant environmental benefits, but the location of this project will result in even greater benefits on the landscape. This site is within the North Fork Crow River watershed, which had recently developed a comprehensive watershed protection plan through the One Watershed, One Plan program. This project will help to achieve some of the priority goals identified in the plan, such as increasing water storage within the watershed, reducing agricultural runoff into nearby lakes and streams, and expanding existing habitats into larger block habitat for wildlife. Here you will see a before construction, during construction, and after construction image of basin number 4 looking west. Water is routed from one wetland to the next wetland downstream during periods of high water. A water control structure with stop logs was installed on the north end of the project and connected to the existing tile system. This structure effectively conveys water back into the tile system when all wetlands are at full capacity. Views of basins 1 and 4 before and after the restoration show the significant transformation that occurred in just one growing season. These wetlands will be protected in perpetuity through a conservation easement held by the state of Minnesota.